You're up to something, McDevious, I can tell. Wait a second. Are you finally getting that sex change operation? Good for you, McGee.
Or is it McShee? No judgment. Proud of you.
Look, Director Vance offered me a job promotion, okay?
He's head of the cyber division in Okinawa.
That's it?
Yes.
Everybody knows that. Tim, good for you. It's fantastic. You gotta take that opportunity. The last cyber agent, he's at Microsoft now.
Yeah, it's head of security. The guy's a rock star.
He's so sarcastic. The CBS drama NCIS TV's top-rated scripted program runs its 200th episode tonight. That's a very big deal. The first person you heard in that clip was Special Agent Tony DiNozzo. He's been around for all of them.
Special Agent, very Special Agent, I think it might be. Yes. Tony DiNozzo is played by Michael Weatherly, who's here to celebrate that milestone with us. Great to have you with us this morning.
It is a deep pleasure and an honor to be with the two most gorgeous women on television.
You say that to all the girls who will take it.
I know. Where are we next? No.
No, we feel it too. But congratulations is in order. I think people are saying, wasn't he on The Cosby Show back in 1984?
Gail is not a single person that says that.
Yeah, playing Theo's roommate. Isn't that the guy? But I think back on your career back then, that had to be a very, very big deal. It's your first starting out. That's
right.
Very cool to be
yes,
there.
Yes, The Cosby Show is a very funny thing because I had nothing on my resume except stuff I made up. It was all completely fictional.
Total lie.
What did you make up? What did give me
you
one
know,
thing you
that
made
I'd
up?
Been in an independent movie and
okay.
that I had done, you know, like things nobody could, because there was no
Summer
IMDb.
Theater.
There was no Google then.
Okay,
you couldn't fact check anybody.
Got it.
So lying was a lot easier. And my manager represented a guy who played Theo's roommate, and he booked a movie with John Turturro and wasn't available. But I was the same size as him. So she called me and said, get out to Queens, you're going to meet Bill Cosby, and if he signs off on you, you're going to be working this afternoon. They're taping.
How nerve-wracking was that when he said you're going to meet Bill Cosby?
I didn't have enough time to get nervous, and I met him, and he was in a tracksuit smoking a cigar. He had a rubber chicken nailed to his dressing room door and a sign about comedy that I don't remember.
Well, apparently you did okay because it launched, I would think, a very successful career for you.
I did okay, but they never invited me back.
Well, there's that.
It was a one-shot deal. Yeah.
But that's
yeah.
okay. We're still talking about it today.
There we go.
So that's a good thing, right? So,
yeah, that's the happy ending.
We were talking a little bit during the break, and you were telling Gail, and in some ways you kind of fell into this. But
yes.
it seemed to have worked out well, and you loved for a long time, you said, this sort of vagabond gypsy life that you have.
Yeah, it's something that you don't really know it until you've lived it, and now it's been over 20 years of working as an actor, which is incredible, and to be able to enjoy the adventures of, like I was saying, living in Australia, and then you're shooting a movie in Germany, and then you go to do a James Cameron TV series in Canada for 2 years with, you know, the most beautiful girl on the planet, and then you come back and do this, and you know, and that's your life, and you kind of wake up going, oh, I guess I'm awake, this is good.
No, and, but when you think, though, Michael, here you sit with the 200th episode, very, very popular show on CBS, so when the character started for you, because he's sarcastic, he's fun, he's smart, is there any part of you in that? Sarcastic and smart and fun? Go ahead, take a sip of your water and then go ahead and answer the question.
This is vodka. How did this get here?
Go ahead.
Charlie?
Go ahead.
What do you mean, sassy? Who's sassy? I think crime procedural is this durable format. And we came into it after there had already been an established Law and Order and the CSIs. And so we were very lucky to have this this opportunity. But at the same time, we needed to brand it a little differently and make it our own. And Mark Harmon really encouraged us all to find our personalities and to put them out there. And Dom Belisario was adamant that I not stand there like a department store mannequin modeling clothing, and that I punch it up and be present. And
you took that to heart.
I did, and they let me ad-lib, and so that was born.
Well, let me just say, when people heard you were coming, people were very excited in the studio. Several people have crushes. I won't name names. Steve. But they were very excited that you were here because he really likes you on the show. He really likes you on the show.
Right.
But this is what I'm most excited about for you. Your wife. The lovely Boyana. Yes, I love how you hold up the wedding
That's
ring.
Right.
That's where I was going.
That's right.
You all expecting a baby girl.
Yes.
Love this. You already have a son.
I do. And
16 and now a newborn. That's a big gap.
That's how I do it.
Yeah, okay.
You know,
that's how you roll.
I do it in these great sort of epic stages.
I got it.
You know.
And they just get their own spotlight for a little while. It's very thoughtful.
right? Because really, well, my grandmother passed away last year at 102.
Whoa.
And my father's father passed away at 104. So I figure if I'm sticking around that long, you know, I take some time between
space
them.
Space it out.
Aren't you excited about having a girl, seriously? I'm so excited that another girl's coming.
I can't. My wife is a doctor as well. So I found myself Saturday morning in a prenatal class. I don't know if you've attended these horror shows.
Yes.
But they roll film. They show movies of the birth.
You can do it. That's in preparation. We've been doing it for years.
You can do it.
Well, great to have you.
And we will catch you tonight in episode number 200 of NCIS, 8/7 Central on CBS.
Yes.